So anyway, as I'm going to through things, I got some, you know, these are from 1994. You know, this particular, I actually remember this because I was inspired by Olivia, the airbrush artist, female airbrush artist, except that I wanted to do something like an ink and black and white that was kind of that style of Olivia. You know, I ripped this out of the piece book. The reason why I'm taking them out is because I want to preserve these drawings from 1994 because they're getting yellow and all this other stuff, so now I got to put them into plastic. But anyway, you know, going back to Olivia, Olivia is just a great, you know, fashion, erotic, she's featured heavily in heavy metal. That's where I got my introduction from her, heavy metal magazine. So she does the airbrush stuff. So I wanted to do kind of like a black and white contrast. I kind of did a poor job of that, of kind of like the style of Olivia, but in ink, not an airbrush. It's very hard to do, but I remember doing this in 1994. So I put that out there. And, you know, it was kind of like this thing where, like, you would have black and have that white blankness supplant regular just details, meaning that I wanted to have it look like it was appearing out of the shadows, which, I don't know, I was 1994, so whatever. So then I end up doing this here. What is this here? Okay. Now, my boy Menace did the BTB letters with the crown. By the way, graffiti crowns, not gangbanger crowns. Always graffiti crowns are three points. A lot of people, you know, that's what really separated graffiti crowns from gangbanger crowns. That's like a no-brainer from way back in the old school days. That's how you would separate there. So that's that. And what I want to talk about here is this was is the designers, man, the old school designer markers. Now, I kind of wish I had a set now, and I'm kind of thinking about ordering a new set on Amazon because, you know, I do so much stuff on a computer. But it's really cool to just have something raw, you know, freehand. Because I do so much inking, and then I kind of ink. After I ink it, I usually scan it in the computer and color it in the computer. But I'm thinking about getting designer markers again. So designer markers are one of their mainstay staple qualities that's beneficial is they don't bleed. In other words, they don't bleed too much in a line. But they, strangely enough, they blend in with each other well. There's also a little colorless blender you can use to help that effect. As a matter of fact, I think over here, these letters are from Cell. Yeah, because they got Riddle, Man of Cell, BTV, 1994. So they did the letters, and I did the little sassy girl character there, 1994 thing. And like I said, you know, I don't draw stuff in the market. I mean, I'm colorblind. A lot of people know that by now. I don't see in black and white. I can see yellow, blue, and orange and all that, but I don't see purple or all these shades that they don't exist in my world because my eyes don't see them. I don't know why that is. So it's a common problem. It's a common medical problem. So a lot of times when I would do graffiti stuff, I would draw girls green. They'd be like, I like your green girls. People would tell me, oh, I like your sexy green girls. I was trying to draw them flesh color, but I did not know I was drawing them green. So I had to look at the name on the cans. So basically, designer markers are highly underrated nowadays because they were a big deal back in the old school days in the 80s and early 90s. But if they're around, I would certainly suggest picking them up and getting them.